My first sighting was in the month of May, 1934. I was standing at the mouth of the River Loch, expecting a run of salmon to come in from Loch Ness. I was looking over towards the Abbey boathouse. Flat, calm, beautiful sunshine, 8 o'clock in the morning. And without warning, this terrific upsurge of water, head, neck, and one sloping long hump. Well, I estimated the head at 6 feet above water level, roughly 200 yards distant, and the body I estimated at 30 feet because in my imagination, I said to myself, two 15-foot boats stem to stern. That would be near enough at that distance. And the head was turning, oh, very nervously. I could see, very nervously. And I wonder, oh dear, what's this, what's this? And I shut my eyes 3 times like that, just to make sure it wasn't imagination. No, it was still there. And then I realized why the nervous state it was in. I heard the engines of 2 small trawlers just leaving the bottom lock of the canal, coming down to enter Loch Ness, you see? And I said to myself, this is going to be interesting, because if the creature remains on the surface until the first trawler appears, its bow will come within my line of vision and its line of vision. And that's what happened. As soon as the bow of the first trawler came in sight, heavens, oh, upsurge, fantastic. Well, I was absolutely, I wasn't scared or anything, I was just dumb, struck dumb, that if I had the finest camera in the world beside me, I couldn't have thought of picking it up, you know, to take a picture. I was so staggered. Anyhow, I went home, looked up my book of prehistoric animals, and the nearest I could find in the book was a picture of the plesiosaur. The plesiosaur. But one thing I did make sure of, the colour of the skin, that particular occasion, I would say it was a slate grey. That was the best, first actually, and best sighting I had all down the years.
Listen to that rain. That was Alex Campbell, who was water bailiff on the Loch for nearly 40 years. He should know.